Okay, so where was I? Yeah, so I had three separate obligations, and because of that, I took a lot of my courses on Saturdays. Three courses on Saturdays, and one course, Social Welfare Policy, on Tuesday evenings. This way, I could fit in my internship and my part-time job into the weekdays. So Mondays and Thursdays, I worked as a tutor, and the other days, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, I was interning at the high school. It seemed really doable, and at first it was. I mean, if I couldn't handle this, then what would that say about my competency, about my work ethic? So I was determined to make this work. The threefold process of learning, applying and demonstrating my learning, and all the while earning my bi-weekly paychecks. I know so many other people have it tougher than this, you know? I know the heart-tugging story, someone going to school and working two jobs and taking care of their children, son and daughters. Compared to that, what I had to push through was easy. But I'll admit here, and I'll probably sound like a spoiled brat for saying this, but to me, it ultimately was not easy. This past semester turned out to be quite a challenging semester. I would do my 8 hours of internship and then take the 50-minute bus ride back home. When I got home, I reminded myself of the articles I had to read, of the process recordings I had to type up, of the case notes to prepare, of all the things I had to do. Work followed me home. I had weekly deadlines to meet, and the only way to do so was to continue working after getting home. And that was the ultimate challenge for me. It was hard to feel motivated to do anything productive once I got home. So a lot of times, instead of doing what I was supposed to be doing, I suppose, I turned on my PS3, or I relaxed on my iPad, or hit the bed hard and fell asleep. For me, one of the best feelings in the world is coming home from a long day at work and switching into my jeans. Jeans really are the most comfortable clothes to me. And at my internship, I have to wear business casual. I have to wear dress shoes, slacks, and these kind of collar shirts. Tie is optional, but I have a cool collection of ties, mostly borrowed from my dad. So why not? I usually go with the tie, and so I look really professional from so most days of the week, from 8 in the morning to 5:40, which is about the time I get home, I'm dressed professionally. And once I get home, the first thing I do is get out of those clothes and into my jeans. It's such a nice, homely feeling. And I think once I do that, the neurons in my brain get wired in such a way that doing anything productive is the last thing on my mind. And that, I think, is the number one reason why this past semester was so challenging for me. It's kind of amazing that I made it past the semester with this kind of serious issue there. Because a number of times, what this meant was that I'd wake up extremely early in the morning, and by that I mean like 2 in the morning or 3 a.m., to get things done, or staying up all night. I tended to distract myself with video games, Netflix, even just reading-wise, I would distract myself with unrelated novels and books. Books and fiction and nonfiction books that are totally not related to my schoolwork or my internship. So more often than not, I met my deadlines, but usually by a hair. A few times, I actually did turn in my stuff to my supervisor past the deadline, and for that, I was reprimanded, and of course, deservedly so. One other thing I'll note is that my signal anxiety was extremely low this semester. And signal anxiety is kind of like social work or psychology jargon, but what it means is it's the type of unease one normally feels regarding deadlines. Like, for example, if you say to a person with a really high signal anxiety that she has an essay due in 2 months, then she'll start working on that immediately. And for the entire 2 months, she'll fret and fret about making that essay being the best as possible. A person with an extremely high signal anxiety can seem rather neurotic. Those perfectionist straight A teacher's pet types, but also overly compulsive about their assignments and their obligations. Now, so a person that usually has extremely high signal anxiety will most likely be very successful in school and work and all that, but usually at the cost of positive friend relationships and health, good health, because the stress level of high signal anxiety is a little intense. This past semester, my signal anxiety, I think, was way too low, so the opposite end. I can't really explain why it was like that, because back in my high school days and my college days, I actually tended to have quite a high signal anxiety. But my first semester as a graduate student, my iPad calendar would warn me that one of my midterms papers was due next week, and still, I had a really difficult time motivating myself to get started on it. And the telltale sign of a low signal anxiety is tendency to procrastinate. And boy, oh boy, this semester I surely procrastinated quite a lot. And this had a huge negative impact, of course, as you would expect. Two of my midterm papers were written in a rushed, disorganized manner. And as you'd expect, my grades on those papers weren't so great. One of my final papers, I had to request an extension. My professor is an extremely flexible and kind gentleman, so the extension wasn't an issue per se, but I really felt bad about myself that I had to resort to that. Ultimately, out of the three obligations, I decided that one had to be cut. Now, I really enjoyed working as a part-time classroom tutor in the elementary school, and the bi-weekly paychecks were quite nice, but my focus right now has to be graduating with an MSW, and I felt that at the rate I was going, I wasn't going to make it. If I failed graduate school because I had overexerted myself doing 12 hours a week on a $14 an hour job, then I would have spent all that expensive college tuition money on pretty much nothing. So I really just needed some days off a week to work on school-related and internship-related things. Of course, I wouldn't have to quit my job as a tutor if I simply manned up, stopped procrastinating, and just have particularly no free time once at home and just do the work that I'm supposed to be doing. But in so many ways, that was easier said than done. I wasn't in the mental and emotional state to just up and transform myself like that. It had to be gradual for me, unfortunately, and too gradual for me to be able to keep my job. So ultimately, I did quit my job as a tutor. Speaking of my emotional state, and I don't like to admit this, probably the least thing I want to admit this right now, but it got really shaky at times, my emotional state. It wasn't just the crushing feeling of being overwhelmed. I mean, that was crippling in itself, but this year, I came to realize just how deeply my work at this homeless shelter has come to affect me, even to now. It's done quite a number on me, actually. As I've mentioned before, my bus rides and to the internship can be about 50 minutes long, sometimes longer than that. It takes a lot less time nowadays because the New York City Transit came up with a new bus route, the selective bus service, but for a long time, it was quite a long commute, if you could consider like an hour commute long. And a couple of times during that commute, I got really teary-eyed, and I started remembering the faces of the homeless clients I come to meet at the shelter. I saw like faces and flashes of them. You know, I come to really witness firsthand the many crazy life stories and routines of the homeless, of the mentally ill, of the disabled, of the chemically addicted, and of many other such populations working there. And thinking back of those faces really shook me, and shook me hard. That's not to say that being a social work intern to high school students is any less impactful, and they themselves have incredible life stories and circumstances to share, but I don't know. The people I've come to know and interact with at that shelter, for a long time, you know, they were my life's purpose. That's pretty much all I lived for and worked for about a year, and it's really not that easy to shake that off, you know. All that said, overall, I think I would evaluate my first semester as a graduate student to be less than stellar. It was more challenging and more overwhelming to me than I had anticipated to be. Nonetheless, somehow I got through it, and that's why I say it's kind of surreal that I'm here now. Graduate school is definitely a different level than undergraduate school, even just judging by the first semester. Hopefully in the end, I can just look back at this semester and, you know, think to myself, meh, that was whatever.